Everybody, welcome back to Slime Fun, and this is Boomer. We're going to be on a SkyGrid server today, simply because I've got some things already in place that's going to help with this episode a little bit more than doing it over in survival. We're talking freezers. The almighty freezer. And you think, well, what does a freezer have to do with Slime Fun, and what do we do with it? Now, I did showcase this in another episode on the SkyGrid series when it came to my nuclear reactor and how we can automate putting together nuclear reactant coolant cells. And so we're going to talk about that. So really, this episode, if you're looking for something in particular, I'll tell you what we're going to talk about with the freezer. We're going to show how to make regular ice, packed ice, blue ice, nuclear coolant reactor cells. And we're also going to talk about obsidian with a freezer. You got that right. Automated 100% obsidian. Got my coffee in one hand. Got my mouse in the other. We're going to have some fun today. So let's start by looking at these freezers in the guide. You have two different freezers, speed one and speed two. They're both found under energy and electricity. Speed one, it's not huge to build. It's a little bit of a challenge. You do have two electric motors. You've got one packed ice. You've got one silver ingot, a medium capacitor, and two cooling units. And so far, these are the only places where I've actually found cooling units. And these are very relatively easy to make. Six ice, two aluminum ingots, and an electric motor. So realistically, you need four motors, a couple of ice, a medium capacitor, and a couple of ingots. Cost scale, difficulty range, I would say low to medium. Now to make an upgraded one, just real quick so you can see this, you can see how much power it makes and it runs at normal speed. When we go up to freezer level two, this runs twice as fast. And requires almost double the power, of course, but all my freezers are level two, with the exception of my ice creation is level one, because even at level one, it outpaces two level twos of mine going further into the ice process. I'm actually going to have to be adding a third level two freezer going from ice to packed ice, blue ice, and reactor coolant cells, simply because it just can't keep up. Two level twos are not keeping up with one level one. Go figure that. This one's a little bit more expensive. You do need two more cooling units, two more electric magnets, and a couple more ingots. It's not insane, so like I said, low to medium cost range. So let's start. They do need to be powered. We do have a carbon auto capacitor here, more than enough power. There's the GUI. If we put in a water bucket into the freezer, it's gonna take about 4 seconds. We get our bucket back, yay. We also get ice. That's how quick you can make ice with water. If you try to do a manual farm, if you've ever set up a manual farm, you know two things, right? First, you gotta have the right biome. Second, you gotta have sky access. Then it becomes, you need a silk touch pick, and you've gotta manually mine all of it, all right? We don't have to do any of that with Slimefun. Because I have an ability to generate infinite water buckets by sending the empty bucket back to the farm, and I'll show you that in a little bit, it can keep the ice thing going. So now that we have plain ice, if we put it into a freezer again, you see it goes a little bit slower. It takes longer to compress that ice down even further. There's our packed ice. So all in all, going from a bucket to ice to packed ice, we can do that in 10 to 12 seconds. But you want blue ice. So let's put the packed ice into the freezer. Get started. Again, a little bit slower than getting the packed ice. But hey, not bad, because you know what? That took roughly 20 seconds to get blue ice. But I have nuclear power plants going. I have three of them on my base. When I redesign and I do the survival world, I'm actually going to be a series of at least 8 nuclear reactors on the base, simply because of what I'm going to be generating. And as time goes along, we'll show you that. But if I put in the blue ice straight up, again, a little bit slower, because it's having to compress something that was compressed that was compressed. But here it comes. We now have nuclear reactant coolant cells. Bingo. Real simple. So if you're using the Slime Fun and you want to network this, you can. You simply on one side put an output node that brings in water buckets. On this side, you'd put an input node that pulls out ice and empty buckets. Empty buckets will get sent back to your automatic filling station. Ice gets attached into here, and you have an output node with ice. Input node on this side would be packed ice. Then it go to blue ice. You put an output node on this side with packed ice, input node with blue ice on this side, and now you can send it to a storage area. Or if you need nuclear reactant coolant cells, you can simply say, okay, great, come to this side. Output node has blue ice, and on the other side, an input node would have reactor coolant cells, and then go to your storage facility. You could even split it up between the two. You could say, I want four of these to save. And so every time ice comes out of here, 50% of it goes to storage, 50% of it goes to becoming packed ice. Out of the packed ice, 50% goes to storage, 50% becomes blue ice, and same thing down the road. 50% goes to storage, 50% becomes nuclear reactant coolant cells. Or you could set up a chain of these. You could have, like I have, this would be the entire chain just for nuclear reactant. I could set up a chain of three for blue ice, a chain of two for packed ice, or one freezer just for regular ice. There's an infinite number of ways to set it up. So I do want to take you back to the back side of the base, and I want to show you again, and I'm pretty sure I did this on a survival series, but I want to show you the automatic water bucket filling system. This is a video build that I did pull from Ilmangle. It had to be modified for 1.14.4 a little bit, and I had to modify it a little bit for what I wanted to have accomplished in Slimefun. But the premise is still the same as what he put together. So if you're on YouTube, search up Ilmangle, I-L-M-A-N-G-O, water bucket filler, or automated water bucket filler, or automated bucket filler. I don't know, pick a term. Anyways, you'll find the video, you'll find a build that won't be with kelp blocks. I think he uses iron blocks and stone, but very basic is that when a water bucket hits the hopper, there's a comparator on the backside, pulls out a signal, sends it into this, which fires the dispenser. In the meantime, that water bucket has made its way into the dispenser. Because you have water sources on either side, this automatically becomes a new source every single time after the bucket pulls water back in. And then I have on this server, we have transporting hoppers. So actually the water buckets for me get sent into this chest, and then networks pull it in here to make ice. Water bucket goes back out, ice keeps coming in. So like I said, one is faster than two of these running to keep up. I don't even have, you know, nuclear reactant coolant cells going yet. These are definitely running, two of them is still slower, so I need to add a third. Now, we also did mention at the offset of this video, at the startup, that we can also automate obsidian. So, well, you say, what is it that gives us obsidian, right? So when you come back into the Slimefun guide, you can see water gives you ice. Ice, packed ice. Packed ice, blue ice, and blue ice, reactor coolant cells. Lava coming into the freezer gives you obsidian. It's almost like you just poured water over the lava, but you can automate it again. So you use a crucible. If you're not sure what a crucible is, let's pull one up here in the guide. And whoops, oh, you know what? I have to turn chat back on again. Gosh darn golly gee. Sorry, guys. Here we go, crucible. If I can spell. Let's just pull up a level one. So as far as crafting, the level one, I would say, is low to medium cost. The two Damascus steel ingots, okay. You have a medium, sorry, large capacitor and a crucible to create. Not huge, so I said low to medium. See, advanced levels can get really high and expensive. If you want a super fast crucible, you're now looking at power crystals, level two, a couple of steel plates. I would say that's medium to higher. You know, it's not insanely expensive with a power crystal because that's a synthetic diamond, some synthetic sapphires and redstone. So I'm going to say it's a good medium cost. But anyways, on all my diamond farms and automatic plant farms, we have crucibles built in. I'll kind of sneak over here to show you. Here we go. Here's my crucible. So I have this running right now. It brings in cobble and empty buckets, and it's going to put out buckets of lava for me. And they're pulling them out so fast you don't actually see it. Anyways, I send them all over to a storage barrel, and then as my Android interfaces require more lava, it automatically ships it over. So if that were tied to the system, as the crucible makes lava, we're simply going to, through the networks, we would import it right into the freezer. And as the lava comes into the freezer, you can see it start to do its thing. Here it takes about, I'm going to say 10 to 12 seconds. And on the other end, you've got another empty bucket and your obsidian. So we would have the obsidian will go to a storage facility, the empty bucket, back to the crucible to get more lava. And you automate that. And if you want to learn more about how to automate that, go back and see the episode I did on networks. I go very in-depth on input and output nodes and cargo connectors and the cargo manager. Just to give you a sneaky peek, coming up here in the near future, we're going to get talking about the CT access terminals for the network and be able to access all your storage from an item frame. Pretty cool. I'm working on that right now as we speak. That's how my entire survival world-based storage will be set up. For now, I'm going to say thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed the episode, hammer that like button. If you're new to the channel, consider subscribing. Turn on notifications so you find out when Boomer's been up to new things. But as always, we have to say it. You got to go, Boomer, or you got to go home. We'll see you later.